Hi everyone, this podcast is about translations of parent functions. It's all about using some basic functions that you already know about, that you know how their graphs look, and trying to create brand new functions using the knowledge of the old parent function. Let's start off by looking at a function x cubed plus 2. What I'd like you to do is think about a basic function that you've seen that looks really close to this function. Think about it. I hope you ended up choosing the cubic function, and looks like this, p of x equals x cubed. The reason why I labeled it p of x is so that you think about parent function of x is equal to x cubed. And quick as a jiffy, just look at your notes or just bring a piece of paper and write up the T chart for P of x equals x cubed. Pause me now and create that T chart. Compare your T chart with mine and make sure that you're on the same page. Now go ahead and create the graph for this function as well. Pause me now. Well, hopefully your graph looks like the cubic function graph that I've drawn right here. Now, what I'd like you to th think about is the table for the new function that we're trying to come up with, which is f of x equals x cubed plus 2. So in other words, you've got to use the information about x cubed to come up with x cubed plus 2 function. So I want you to fill out this T chart knowing the fact that you've already calculated x cubed right here in all of these spots for the inputs negative 2, negative 1, 0, and so on. You already know the x cubed value. What you're doing is calculating x cubed plus 2. So all you have to do is really look at negative 2 cubed, which is negative 8 right here, plus a 2. So that should have been negative 6, and so on. Fill out this table and come back and check your answer. Hopefully your table values corresponds with the one that I have right here. I hope you took special notice of the fact that x cubed plus 2 is just 2 more than every one of the output value here, which makes sense because you've already created the x cubed table and all you're doing is adding 2 to each one of them. Now go ahead and in this same graph right here, draw the x cubed plus 2 graph, the f of x graph, on the same grid with maybe a different color pen. And come back and check your answer again. Pause me now, please. So hopefully your two graphs look like the one on the grid that I've shown. And as you can tell, the new f of x graph is shifting the old parent graph up by 2. That should make sense because every output that you used to have in the old parent graph is now has now been added by 2 more, so it moves up by 2. Every one of those values is adding a 2 to the output and moving it up. So the entire graph moves up by 2. So the best way to think about this is take a special point, like the important point being the origin, and see where that travels to. If when you see that the important point 0, 0 right here in your table has moved up by 2, you can easily imagine the entire graph moving up by 2. All right, so this is called a vertical translation. Now we'll think about other sorts of translation. All right, so here's a new graph, g of x, where it seems a little similar to the previous function that we looked at. However, notice that before applying a cubic function, you're actually subtracting the input by 2. So in other words, you're not performing, you're not really cubing anything until you subtract the input by 2. So it's a little bit different from before. So what I would like you to do is to figure out the t-chart of this function based on, I'm not sure whether you can really base it on this t-chart that I've given you on x cubed. I would say just go ahead and calculate x minus 2 whole cubed for every input of x here, and perhaps add a few more values in x just to see a pattern, and go ahead and draw the graph here as well of g of x on top of the graph that contains x cubed, and then come back and compare your answer. All right, so compare your t-chart, and I hope you saw the pattern that I'm seeing, which is that the zero value here, the input value 0 in g of x now has a negative 8, which is right there. And the 1 value has an output of negative 1, which matches up with that. And the 2 value now has a 0, and so on. So there seems to be a shift of some kind. So let's try plotting the graph itself and noticing what the graph looks like. So make sure that you draw the graph and come back and check your answer. So compare your two graphs with mine, and notice that I just plotted these points from 0 through 4, mainly because I can't really fit negative 64 and negative 27 on my graph that's a small grid. But as you can see, the entire graph, the parent graph, moved over or shifted to the right by 2. And you can justify that mainly by looking at the important point, the old important point on the parent function. And you notice that the value that it takes in the new graph is 2 comma 0, because the value 2 produces the old value 0 in the important point. And so it's as though you yanked the entire graph and moved it over to the right. So the main thing, the main idea, if you can grasp out of these two different examples, is that when the input changes with a addition or subtraction of a number, it shifts left or right. And when you add a number outside the parent function, then the whole graph shifts up or down, which is a vertical translation. So let's put these two ideas together and do one more example, and then we'll have the idea settle in completely. So here's an example where we combine two different translations, vertical and horizontal. So let's take a look at the h of x function. That seems to first subtract 1 from the input, and then it cubes it, which means you apply the parent function x cubed at that point. You're cubing x minus 1. And then you add 4. So it's a combination of those translations that we've seen before. The subtract 1 to the input, what it does is a translation to the right by 1. That's what we've seen before. We saw a translation by 2 before, and now in this particular case, it's a translate right by 1. So in other words, take that important point and see where it moves. Well, the first thing it did was to translate to the right. So it moved the x value of that important point became a 1. So 0, 0 right here moved over Somewhere there. Now we're going to do one more translation because of add 4, that moves it up by 4. So right here. So the y value became 4. So the important point moved from 0, 0 to 1 comma 4. So imagine that you had a push pin and it was holding the purple graph together with the grid right here. And I'm going to yank out that push pin and take that whole purple graph and plug it right there. How would that look like? Let's see if I can draw this quickly. There you go. That red graph that you see is exactly what I just talked about, taking the purple graph and just moving it over from 0, 0 to 1, 4. So hopefully you understand how to combine those ideas of translations and create new graphs. And I will stop now, and you should be very successful with your homework in combining ideas about translations. Thank you, and we'll see you again tomorrow or day after.